you see many more dancers now across the world, across the state, getting involved, young kids. But we have to be careful as well. We have to show all the elements that are involved in dance, being the feeling and the style, the individuality, all the things we talked about. We have to keep showing kids that it's not just what you're seeing on TV, of course. It's what you're seeing in your backyards, in your garages, in the youth centers, wherever you're at, wherever you're dancing, wherever you feel like dancing. We have to show them that's still important. Because I've been around the world now, and the new topic for discussion as it pertains to b-boying is what is happening to our dance? What is happening to the culture now? Because it seems like now the big thing is the big jam, the big money, the prize money, the big contest. Everyone's working towards this one competition. That's all they care about. They're really focused on that money. They need to pay their bills, so they need to make that prize money. But what happens if they don't? You know? It's like we have to continue to dance for the love of it. We have to continue to see all the important things. Because yeah, that big money, that big prize, that TV status, that spotlight is important. But so is just dancing for the fun of it. At a party or at a block party where your friend's garage or something. That's just as important. So we need to just continue to keep showing the youth that you can't just focus on one part of the dance. You have to take that whole thing and love that whole dance and the whole culture around it. And that's pretty much going to give you longevity in this. And that's about it. That's
about it. If I may, one of the things that we talk about is dancing and having that emotional connection to the music. If I could just offer this as a thought for you guys to take away, that, a lot of times we say, we can teach you movement, but it's hard to teach you the feeling. And I think what might be a way to help that situation is if you understand music, really understand music by studying music, and if you think of your body as a scale, where all your lower notes are from the waist down, the treble and things are going up, your feet being the only horizontal thing on your body, you have the same thing, so that's how, when you're making bass, you use the heat. When you connect with music in that way, you understand the tonal quality of music, that if you're listening to something and the instrumentation or the vocalization is sustained, that maybe your movement is sustained. If it's sudden, maybe your movement is sudden. If it's vibrato, you use that in your movement. If it's a heavy bass sound, maybe your movement is overflowing. Maybe it's heavy. Or if it's a lighter note, maybe you're floating or something like that. So you connect to the emotional tonality of the music to express the movement that we have inside of us. And maybe that'll be a way to connect to the music in a different light if we can't take musical classes. So I just wanted to leave you guys with that.